In this video, we are going to show you one taping technique using rigid tape in patients with patellofemoral pain syndrome. Enroll in our online course now. Link is in the video description. Hi, and welcome to Physiotutors. If you have been following Physiotutors for a while, you probably know that we are big proponents of active rehabilitation and that we critically look at passive modalities. However, we also acknowledge that there is a time and place to use passive treatments and that they can be a useful tool to reduce pain in early stages of rehab that will facilitate the patient to perform targeted exercises and thus increase patient compliance and enhance recovery. Particularly, patella taping is a useful adjunct for pain relief in the initial management of PFPS, and a variety of taping methods have been reported in the literature. Crossley et al. In 2000 showed that the tailored McConnell taping promoted pain reduction and resulted in improved function in patients with PFPS. In the 2015 consensus statement on PFPS, medially directed patella taping had level 1 evidence in immediate pain reduction. So, let's take a look at the taping technique. Let's first look at what type of tape we're going to use. So first of all, you'll need a stretchy adhesive fabric tape as a base and to prevent skin irritation. And then secondly, the tape that's going to do the job essentially is a rigid non-stretch tape. You can find the link to all the tapes in the description down below. All right, now to apply the tape, I've done a couple of things in preparation. First of all, in order for the tape to be able to stick, the skin should be shaved. I have also prepared 3 strips of base tape. One that spans from medial to lateral above the patella, and then 2 other strips that roughly span 2/3 across the knee below the patella, from medial to lateral. Okay, let me show you how to apply the tape. I will apply the tape on myself, as the patient should be able to do it at home as well. So the first bit of tape is going to be applied above the patella, half on and half off. Even though the tape is stretchy fabric, we are going to apply it without any tension, so just tape it across. The next piece of tape is going to start at the tibial tuberosity and then go medially, again without tension. And we're going to do the same for the third piece. So start at the tibial tuberosity and apply it laterally. The patient should still be able to move the knee freely into flexion and extension, and the kneecap should be able to move freely as well, as we haven't applied any tension to the tape at all. Make sure the tape doesn't come off with the movement. Now we're going to apply the rigid tape. Okay, so this first bit of tape, we're gonna anchor it down on the patella just in the middle. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna lift the skin up medially so you see skin folds develop. And then we're gonna pull the patella medially and anchor the tape down. Then we take another bit of tape. We're gonna anchor it down laterally. Then we're gonna lift up the skin again, pull it across the kneecap, and anchor it down medially as well. So now we already have a medial translation of the patella. Lastly, we're going to take some pressure off the infrapatella fat pad. The first bit of tape is going to go from the tibial tuberosity in medial direction. So we're gonna anchor it down in the middle. Like so. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull up the skin on the inside of the knee. Like so. And we anchor it down. So now there should be some skin folds on the inside of the knee. And now we're gonna do the same on the lateral side of the knee. So we take one strip of tape, we anchor it down medially on the tibial tuberosity. Then we pull up the skin, really pull up the skin laterally,
pull it across, anchor it down, and release. The patient should still be able to flex and extend the knee without the tape coming off. This might take a couple of minutes to really set, but once that's done, you can try a provocating activity such as walking stairs and see if this eases symptoms. You could also use more layers of base tape to apply even more anchors to your ankles in case the tape doesn't hold well, but usually that's not necessary. You can then test provoking activities such as a step down or walking stairs to see if this reduces symptoms. Usually, depending on the patient's level of activity, the tape can stay on for 3 to 4 days, even with showering, but some patients may need to reapply it after 1 to 2 days. All right, thanks for watching this video. If you want to learn more about rehab of patellofemoral pain syndrome or how to treat other running-related injuries, make sure to check out our online courses with Claire Robertson and Benoit Matthew. The links are in the video description down below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't yet. In the video to the left, we show you another technique using kinesio taping. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I will see you next time. Bye.